sleep apnea is really emerging as an important risk factor for atrial fibrillation. First of all, I should probably explain what sleep apnea is. Sleep apnea is a disorder in the breathing pattern when one is sleeping, such that people don't have enough oxygen in their blood and they have periodic spells of not breathing. Usually how people figure out that they have sleep apnea is a couple ways. A family member may notice that not only does the person snore, but it looks almost like they're gasping for air, or they've stopped breathing for a little bit, usually for, you know, a couple of seconds. But it can be a little frightening to a family member. So if a family member says you're snoring and it looks like you're stopping breathing, it's very important to check in with your physician. Now, if somebody lives alone, how are they going to know that? Well, they may know it because during the day, they can't wake up. You know, they just notice that they're sleepier than a normal person. Like they went to bed, they got 8 hours of sleep, but they somehow, when they wake up, they don't feel as fresh as they used to. And the reason why it's important to get the diagnosis of sleep apnea is, you can imagine if somebody has, you know, a job, for instance, driving a truck, and they're sleepier than normal because they aren't getting a good night's sleep, that could be very serious. And we also know that potentially treating the sleep apnea can just make people feel better. Now, why is it related to atrial fibrillation? Well, there's an emerging story that sleep apnea predisposes, or at least is associated with atrial fibrillation. They not uncommonly happen together. And if people don't get their sleep apnea treated, the atrial fibrillation is more likely to run on for a long time.